Welcome to this new Inside Code video where we will see a new coding problem, the isSubsequence problem. This problem says, given two strings str1 and str2, create a boolean function that checks if str2 is a subsequence of str1. And you have four examples below, so pause the video and try to solve the problem before watching the solution. Before discussing the solution, I want to tell you that I released a free course on time and space complexity. Hundreds of people already joined, you will find the link in the description. You can also activate captions and know that you can find the solution code of this problem in the description in four programming languages: Python, Java, C++, and JavaScript. So don't forget to have a look on it after watching this video. Now let's see the solution. First, what is a subsequence? We consider str2 as a subsequence of str1 if we can find it in str1 even with characters separated. To understand better, here we have the string inside code, and we can have this subsequence, this subsequence, this subsequence, this subsequence, and many other ones. So the brute force solution of this problem would be to generate all the subsequences of str1 then to search for str2. But this solution is really inefficient, because having a string of n characters, we can make 2 power n subsequences, which is huge, so let's see a better solution. What we want to do here to know that str2 is a subsequence is to find its characters in str1 even if they are separated. So it's possible to find the first character, then nothing happens for some characters, then to find the second character, and so on. So we start by the first character on str2, and while traversing, if we find it, then we will continue to search for the second character. Then once we find it, we move to the third character, and all that while traversing str1. At the end, if we find all characters of str2 when traversing str1, it means that str2 is a subsequence of str1. Okay, but how can we implement this solution? We said that we are traversing str1 while keeping track on which character of str2 we are searching. And a very good way to do that is to use the two pointers technique. We put one on the first character of str1, we can name it ptr1 for example, and one on the first character of str2, we can name it ptr2 for example. Then we compare str1 at ptr1 with str2 at ptr2 each time. And if they are equal, we move both pointers to search for the next character of str2 and to continue walking on str1. Else if they are not equal, we move ptr1 only to continue searching. And all that while ptr1 is smaller than length of str1 and ptr2 is smaller than length of str2, because we don't want to go out of bounds. After the loop, to know if str2 is a subsequence, ptr2 must have gone until the end. In other words, it must be equal to length of str2. So we return the equality test, ptr2 is equal to length of str2. To understand better how will these two pointers move, let's see two examples. The first example will have this input, and this is what's gonna happen. Now we have ptr2 being equal to length of str2, which is 4, so str2 is a subsequence. Second example, we have this input, and this is what's gonna happen. Now, after the loop, ptr2 isn't equal to length of str2, so it's not a subsequence. If we take a look on the Python code of this solution, first we define our function isSubsequence that takes two parameters str1 and str2, then we create and initialize ptr1 and ptr2. Then while ptr1 is smaller than len of str1 and ptr2 is smaller than len of str2, if str1 at ptr1 is equal to str2 at ptr2, we increment both ptr1 and ptr2. Else, we increment ptr1 only. After the loop, we just return the equality test, ptr2 equal to len of str2. For the time complexity of this solution, it's O of n, where n is the length of str1, because we are just traversing str1. And for space complexity, we aren't using additional space except simple variables like ptr1 and ptr2, so it's constant. We can also write the same solution but with recursion, and to find the code of both, click on the first link in the description. And don't forget to get the free course on time and space complexity, and please give me your feedback about this video in comments, and see you in the next one.